Hey everybody, welcome to the Dad Challenge Podcast. My name is Josh. Thank you for joining me on this channel. Happy Canadian Thanksgiving. By popular request, I have been asked to make the Micah Stauffer peanut butter chewy specialty cookies galore, or whatever she calls them. And I've got all the recipe here. I've got it all ready to roll. And I've got the lighting, hopefully as close as I can get it. I don't have a potato to film with and my microphone, I have to have good audio, I'm sorry. But that being said, I have recreated, I think, everything that she has for the recipe. We're gonna make the recipe. We're gonna go through it. We're gonna see how it tastes at the end and see if she was lying about how chewy and awesome it was, because I don't think it's gonna be. So, again, thank you for watching that video. They're really fun for me. I've been, you know, a lot of people like them. Some people are saying stop talking about them, but I'm never gonna stop talking with everybody. I've been chatting with people in the comments and stuff. They said it's about time you stop bullying them or everything. And I said, hey, remember when they adopted a kid from China? Remember when they, you know, bought a new $700,000 house, two Range Rovers, BMW, they duct taped his thumb, they put him to bed early so they could hang with their bio kids. They basically did, you know, hired full-time people to take care of him. And then when it got too hard, when she realized that he was gonna have to live with them forever and that he might have to be assisted to use the bathroom for the rest of his life, they rehomed him. They didn't tell anybody. Then they went to Bali. I've got a video coming out this week that is gonna explode with information that you've never even heard from someone close to and ongoingly close to Micah and James. And so if you don't wanna hear about Micah and James anymore, don't watch this one, okay? Don't watch these ones. But I'm not gonna stop talking about it until James and Micah are off YouTube. Because I have a feeling, especially when you watch this video coming out, that there's something coming up and I feel like they're gonna try to make their comeback, especially on the Micah Stauffer side. So, that being said, let's have a little bit more fun with this. Make these cookies exactly the way she made them. Let's taste test them and have some fun, all right? So, one thing I don't have is a wooden spoon, like especially a haunted one from the forest because my dog ate it, but I have this plastic spoon. I have whisks, which is probably what you're supposed to use. And I think based on my wife, who is a baker, and people who, many comments that I read, will go through what Micah did wrong. Because I didn't know, maybe sort of knew, but not really. But let's do the recipe and we'll talk as we go, okay? So first thing you're gonna do is talk like this. Hi everybody. And then you get your hair, make sure your hair is down so it goes in all the food. And then what you do is you put, I think she started with 1 cup of sugar, which we have here, 1 cup of sugar. Put it in there. Which by the way, I'm told, Kathy, am I correct? Sugar is a wet ingredient. Ding, she got that one wrong. So sugar is a wet ingredient, but we're gonna make it the way she is. So I put the 1 cup of sugar in here, 3 cups of flour, and remember, gradually. Okay, just make sure you put that in gradually. She stirred it, and I counted 10 times. And it wasn't even a stir, it was more of a sift. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. She poured it over the edge a little bit. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, okay? Okay, 10 times. Then she put in, what did she put in next? A teaspoon of baking powder? Baking powder, I think that's what this is. Whatever it is, it's the right one. Teaspoon of that, put those on there. Okay, that's a dry ingredient. And she mixed it up another 10 or 15 times. Okay, mixing it up, spilling it over the edge a little bit. Okay, okay. And then she put 1/2 cup of brown sugar in there. Okay, got it. And we're gonna stir that up with everything else. And she, the thing about the brown sugar is that she stirred it the least. The least. So I'm just gonna give it a little bit and I'm gonna leave it kinda right there. Boom. The haunted wooden spoon is not here, I'm sorry. It's one of the things. So she, that was her dry ingredient bowl. So I'm gonna put that over here. We're gonna bring my wife's mixer. Can I use this mixer, Kathy? My wife's pride and joy mixer. Because we don't have a hand one. Plug this bad boy in. Okay, I think it's, yeah, okay. Should I use the, no, she used a whisk because she had the whisk one, right? So I'm gonna use the whisk beater. I'm gonna put it on here. I have an engineering degree to get this right. Okay, so I'm gonna make sure this is down here because it might be hitting my mic. Okay, so I've got this in here. So what she does now, she adds 2 eggs. Let's get those eggs. It's not unusual to be loved by anyone. Doo-doo-doo. 2 eggs. 1. Oh, shoot, there's a shell in there. Okay guys, I'm not a baker, so, okay, I'm a YouTuber. I'm not even a YouTuber. Another egg.
Oh, some shell, just get rid of that. Two bits of shell. Nothing worse than biting into something and having an eggshell. It's like, that's what makes me gag the most. Like eggshell, okay. I will pay Jeff $100 to eat an eggshell. Okay, then she puts 2 teaspoons of vanilla extract, which I have here, but she uses organic. I don't have organic, so we're just gonna go with the old, good old fashioned, whatever this is. Spoons of vanilla extract. I feel like she did way more than this because in the video it looked like way more, but I'm gonna go with what she said. 2 teaspoons of that, that's in. My hands are sticky, it's gross. Then, okay, here's the piece de resistance. I tried to figure out how she got the mayonnaise style butter. I found out how to do it. So I put margarine, it's called, I found the cheapest margarine I could find because I didn't, my wife thinks that butter would be this consistency, but I don't believe her. So I found, I can't believe it's not margarine, or I can't believe it's not butter. And I put it in there, put it in the microwave for like 15 seconds, then I let it sit, and now it is literally the consistency of mayo. So I'm pretty sure this is it. So we're gonna throw that in there. And you gotta hit it really hard. Amazing, incredible. Now I'm gonna put the peanut butter in. I think it was peanut butter. 1 cup of peanut butter. And I'm pretty sure she was going through the vegan phase at that point. She's probably used gross, like no flavor peanut butter. I don't buy that stuff, so I only have normal peanut butter. So you'll have to forgive me for using normal peanut butter. So let's do that. To all the bakers out there who reached out to me and all their, in the comments, I love it. I love that you guys are out there baking goodies and deliciousness and were super offended by this baking video. I did find a post, somebody sent me a post in the Facebook group where Micah claims she's a personal chef. Now, I don't know if that was a joke because she's a mom, because all moms are personal chefs, but she's not a personal chef. Anyway, so we're gonna mix this the way she did it. Do I have to lock this, Kathy? Okay. And then would I put on 1 or 2? Okay, 1. Okay, 1. Okay, that looks gross. Okay, so keep that going. Till it's all mixed in, I guess. It's not hitting the side of the bowl, Mom. How do I do that? Okay. What if it hits the spatula and tears off my arm? Ah, jeez. Don't break it. You're getting that in there. Open it up. I'm gonna add a little bit of the flour mixture. Okay. Remember, this is not mixed very well because she didn't. It's on purpose. So she added about, I wanna say like that much. Okay. Good. Unlock it. Ugh. Put a little bit more of the flour in there. She doesn't say how many times she does it, but I'm just gonna put it all in there now. I'm not gonna lie, it smells like peanut butter cookies, so. Oh, I think we're getting there. Yeah. Okay, I think we're getting the consistency now of the dog food texture that she had in the video. I like that, let's see. Yeah, that's the consistency she had, okay? Awesome, okay. As per Micah's instructions, you need 2 plates just because you need to make more mess. You roll your cookie out, so 1, so dumb. So you grab your cookie dough, you roll it about, if you can, I'm trying. Roll that bad boy in sugar. This is my favorite part of the whole thing, actually. Okay, which is weird, I don't have ever seen anybody do that. You flatten it out. And you make a whole bunch more. And then you transfer it from this plate to this plate, and then you do it up. And then you transfer it to a baking sheet with tin foil. Just a lot of dishes, just saying. I hate dishes. But that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna roll these up, make about 10 of these. This is giant bowl of stuff. Like I'm not making all that, but I'm gonna do what she did. Oh, it's pretty flaky. I don't know how she got away with that. And done that, we're gonna transfer it over to a baking sheet. Oh my God. Another thing that she got wrong apparently was that she's not supposed to use tin foil. Supposed to use parchment paper or something, right? Okay. Yep. And so here's the cookies. They go in the oven for 11 minutes at 350. It's hot. Alexa, set a timer for 11 minutes.
11 minutes, starting now.
Well, we're waiting for the cookies to bake. Let's talk about what happened to that channel. Micah has clearly seen these videos and has taken down the channel. Well, not the channel, she's taken the videos or privated them off of the channel, which is... Here's the thing about being Micah and James. If they've tried so many things that I think that they've forgotten about other things that never worked and they just left it out there, like Micah Balasari and her weight loss juice cleanse. Video comes out this week, you're gonna find out a lot more. Specifically about their apology video and the things that went on behind the scenes and some crazy dirt that they did. And so the reason I want to continue doing this is because James still has Stoffer Garage just pumping lots of money into their bank account. And at this point, it's not over yet. And so when I took my poll about what you guys wanted me to continue to talk about, this was the number one topic. You guys want me to keep this at the forefront. Now, a lot of YouTubers will not, and they feel like a lot of people think I'm, you know, are you done with this yet? And they're rolling their eyes. And the thing is like, I'd love to be done. When they get off the internet, I'll be done with it. And so I think it speaks a little bit more about the kind of channel I am too, because I am not just onto the next hot topic. Now, you know, I do cover specific topics at length, and I think that's what I'm gonna continue to do. I think that's important, but this one topic is just not something I'm willing to let go of as of yet, until, you know, justice is done for H, for sure, at minimum. And, you know, there's been updates about where H is, and maybe he's in a better place, and I hope so, and that's awesome. And this is justice for H in the end. That's what this is all about. This isn't really about just me, and, you know, everybody's gonna roll their eyes and say, no, he's just monetizing. Hey guys, I monetize these videos, I absolutely do. I monetize them in spite of James and Micah, literally because of what they did. And people are coming to watch it. And the time that I take to do this stuff is very time consuming. And so it's a tired argument, and you gotta stop using it, because if you were mad at everybody for monetizing YouTube, then you should go be mad at everybody for talking about everything. And not to mention half the people that are complaining to me about that I monetized the tea of this thing are all engrossed in all of the other tea on YouTube. So you're big time hypocrites. That being said, I do hear you. But I'm not gonna drop this topic. And so again, it's maybe not for you, but I will always continue to cover all the topics, and I will always continue to give voice to those people who don't have a voice. And when you hear this video that comes out this week, I hope I'm not over talking it. I don't think I can actually. You'll see why I'm gonna continue to do this. It's just not done. It is not finished, because there's still more, and they're still continuing to, like, a lot of people are like, well, maybe they've got remorse, you know, they've been punished enough, the YouTube and you know, TMZ and all these magazines and articles about them, you know, they have top 20 famous people who, like, ruined their life with one stupid move on YouTube, and they're in that list. And a lot of people are like, you know, haven't they had enough? And this is why, this video comes out this week, you're gonna hear and you're gonna see that they don't even see it. They're not actually seeing the ramifications. They're not sitting there moping about, well, maybe. But Micah's not sitting there moping about being like, what have I done? You're actually gonna hear in this video coming up, there's a little bit of a teaser, is that she's like, what? I don't get why people are so mad. And she's just planning her comeback. So that's why I'm gonna continue to do this. That's why I'm gonna make these dumbass cookies, and that's why I'm gonna continue talking about her, even if it's making fun of her, to put her at the forefront of pop culture and on my channel, so that she's not forgotten. Because when she does come back, it's gonna be explosive. And I think that she's gonna come back. They have no choice. What else is she gonna do? She can't bake, she can't be a nurse, she can't do anything. YouTube was what she had, her fake voice and fake mom, her fake hot mom video stuff, that's all she had. And so if you don't think she's gonna come back, you're wrong. And so that's why I'm gonna keep this fresh. I'm gonna apologize to those who don't think I should, I'm sorry, but I will not let this go. I hope you can forgive me or see past it or just check out my other stuff, because, you know, and those who are saying that this is all I do, I don't know if you've seen the other 155 videos I have up on my channel. But this is, you know, this is about 30 videos I've done of Mike and James, and I will not stop. But I've got another 120 videos of other things, so you can go check those out. Some of them are cool, some of them are not. But anyway, let's get these cookies out of the oven, and let's do this together. All right, it's been 11 minutes. Let's get some oven mitts out. Ooh, look what my wife has up. This is where she hides it. So my wife hates flies with all her heart. Freaking hates them. She can't go to sleep if there's a fly in the house. Like, if there's a fly anywhere in the house, not like in our bedroom, but if there's a fly. So I bought her this salt gun. It's called Bug Assault. You load it with salt and you cock it and you shoot salt and it, oh, kick the safety off. It kills the flies with salt. Let's pull these cookies out. Cancel this. Get safety gloves on for safety first. All right. Whew. They're the right consistency of color, that's for sure. White. Let's grab a spatula. Got my spatula. So she pulled them off and she didn't have a cooling tray, so she put them on the old plate. So let's do that. One goes there. And then this one, she drops. Oops. Okay, so we're gonna keep piling those on there. Mine are even a little darker than hers. Maybe she did use butter. Maybe my wife is right. Maybe that butter can be that consistency. But I can't believe it's not margarine. So, got those. Get the, oop, that's hot. Yeah! Smells like flour. All right, everybody, my wife, you know, she's not coming on camera, but my son Tristan likes food. All he does is actually eat food. Tristan, come on into the frame here. just eat it. Okay, big bite, big bite. Take a chew. Are they chewy? They're kind of a little bit dry, eh? A little bit.
Have a glass of water.
Why? Just swallow it. You'll be good. You're gonna do. it's dry, right? Thanks, buddy. Tristan, everybody. Thanks, dude. Okay, so basically, what she got wrong was she mixed the wet ingredients wrong. So the sugar, the two sugars, and the needed to go in with the eggs and the liquid ingredients because it melt. I guess it dissolves it and it turns it into. So that's one thing she got way wrong. These cookies are super dry. I'm pretty sure that even mine are crisper or even more squishy than hers, because when James picked that up. Like that thing disintegrated into it, like it was almost dusty. So these are very similar to that, but even mine, I think, maybe it's because I use margarine, she used butter, I don't know. They are not good, is the short answer. 2 Micahs out of 10 on the old cookie scale. They're not good at all. They're not good. I think a lot of people commented on the way to make peanut butter cookies is 3 ingredients. I think it's sugar, peanut butter, and eggs. That's all you need to make a good peanut butter cookie. So let that be a lesson. Don't follow Micah's baking advice. She is a personal chef though. So take that with a grain of salt, because I'm sure she didn't use salt in this other than you're supposed to. But thank you for watching the Dad Challenge podcast. If you're gonna make these cookies, let me know what you think. They're just, it's still in there. It's just making its way down right now. So thanks for watching this video, guys, and stay tuned this week. A couple of big videos coming out. I'm gonna be talking about Sean Fucht from Bethel tomorrow about his COVID super spreader worship parties. And we're gonna come this week with the new Micah video. I'm just gonna edit a little bit of the things out there that my source asked me to edit out. So I will do those edits and then we'll release it probably by Tuesday or Wednesday. So stay tuned for that, guys. Make sure you go buy a shirt below Teespring to help support my channel. Like, thumbs up or thumbs down, I don't care. Leave a comment, engage with this video however you want. Share it if you want. And I love you and I hope you have an amazing Canadian Thanksgiving, even though you're American. Be thankful for something. I'm thankful for you. And I hope that you guys can pay that forward this weekend. Go do something nice for somebody. Be very nice. Be awesome. Westy, come here. Come say bye, buddy. Do you want a cookie? Come here. Come here. You want a cookie?
Yeah.
Try a cookie, buddy. Take one. Take this one.
No.
I hope you have an amazing rest of your weekend. We have a long weekend here, so I got another day off tomorrow. I'm excited about the videos coming out this week. I hope that you have an amazing day. Next Saturday is my last fireside for the season. It's getting too cold. My neighbor keeps calling the bylaw. So I don't want to be a bad neighbor, but at the same time, I don't want to freeze to death. So we're going to bring it back when it gets a little bit warmer. In the meantime, maybe we'll figure out something else and we'll talk and do something. But thank you for watching the Dad Challenge podcast. Thank you for being here for this whole journey, this Micah journey. It's not coming to an end, but it's coming to a head this week. There's some big stuff happening. So thank you. I love you. Amazing. Happy Thanksgiving.